it mentions pneumatic tyres. Right, which was actually guess the age, right? And the other thing about the song is I always forget to read at the end of the line. And so I've got this third paper, illuminating pull up. If I ever end the line, you've got to live that up to 90 degrees. Right. Rafferty's paper is a wonderful animal, but like a bastard's tall and stout. Rafferty's pig was a wonderful animal, but like a batch of old and said, his ignorance would have disgraced any cannibal, and if it had no hope, he snout. The night broke, there was such a commotion, the women were screaming and men turning pale, running and jumping, colliding and bumping, and everyone making a gravity steal. And making us all the heavyman champion, ran with the pig with a big on the pin. Struggled a blow on Mrs. Monroe, shifted her muscle right under her chin. With him alone, fell for a shot in the roof, because he damn red herring she made. She decked some marks all over her glasses and night drove Rafferty's pig ran away. If a man would please swallow the cheese, swallowed the Bible and drove it for a day. Said it goes for the case with the local solicitor, said that the witness is all kiss of the pig. The pig was the bride of the principal witness and ran in the rush to the court of the cans. He rolled in the butter and dashed in the gutter, and that's how he kept the end of their hands. Fat Mrs. Berkshire rallying an elephant talking home with one in a quiet. Felt the ground beat on the sound, just like the slit of a pneumatic tyre. Flying a dog, the pig hit a corner, jumped onto his back and ran into a drain. At 27, his home was in heaven, and I could go round his pig on a wheel. Bloodthirsty crowd and invited her off in the chase with infectious and dirty to cork, and did this way, and she pulled the dust and jumped in front of the park. In front of the leg, well, Councillor Duffy, a man in your standing and lots of ideas. The boy in a colliding home with your backside, standing 25 years. First one leg was broken and shattered, he did his back shed and doctor at once. Barn your toes, and don't be a fool, it's a hammer, a saw, and a joint you want. Then in the news, the pig had been captured in town, and the Thanksgiving supper they say. On cabbage and bacon, and awfully taken, and I took a Rafferty's pig ran away.
Fortune weighed down in the mind. saying that.
Yeah, I've got a great time reading. One of the things in it is how much square area each person should have to work. Do you know how that's worked out? It's because people never used to get washed, and the actual area of air around you was actually how much the neighbour to you could actually take in terms of body weight. That's how they actually worked the things out in the first place. And then you had to pit their baths, and then people had baths in their own home. But the thing is, the moment you have a bath, the whole new problem comes to light. And I'll tell you about it. I remember the words. I have fought a grizzly bear, trapped a lion to its lair, killed a crocodile that dares across my path. But there's one thing that I dread when I've just got up to bed, is to find that there's a spider in the bath. I have no fear of wasps or bees, mosquitoes only tease, and I rather like a cricket on the hearth. But my blood runs cold to meat in pyjamas at their feet, with a great big hairy spider in the bath. I have thought of charging one in Barcelona, torn a lioness from its club. I have returned a mad gorilla to its owner, but I just can't face that tub. What an awful little beast, half an inch across at least. It would frighten even Superman agar, with contempt of county skies and its beady little eyes. That nasty little spider in the bath. It bore a fiery lunge with a bathroom and the sponge. I bombed it with a present from the nun. With a cross into a ball, it just doesn't mind at all. That nasty little spider in the bath. For weeks, we've been locked in endless struggle. I lured it to the deep end down by the drain. But when I dig a cup on it down the plug hole, here it comes a crawling up. I started to hide. Now it's time for me to shave, for my nerves will not behave. I'm sure there'll be a fearful aftermath. But before I cut my throat, I shall be this little note, driven to it by the spider in the bath.
Shone on that plain so bright as he bravely walked on.
sons and fathers far away from families of their own. Young Sanders played a squeeze box and they had a violin. This curious and unlikely band of men. Soon daylight stole upon us and France was France once more. With sad farewells we all began to settle back to war. But the question haunting every heart that beat that wondrous night, whose family have I fixed within my sights? It was Christmas in the trenches and the frost so bitter home. The frozen fields of France were warm, the songs of peace were sung. But the walls they built between us to exact the work of war had been crumbled and were gone forevermore. My name is Francis Tulliver, in Liverpool I dwell. Each Christmas comes as World War One. I can't remember the next line. Each Christmas comes as World War One has learned its lessons well. That the ones who call the shots won't be among the dead and lame. And on each end of the rifle we're the same. Thank you.
three.
Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he has a thousand men. He marched them up to the top of the hill, they marched them down again. And when they were out, they were out. And when they were down, they were down. And when they were out, they were halfway up, they were either up or down.
Still, it's a little few. I'll tell you what, make it a bit easier. We'll leave out the word up. All the rest.
Oh, my darling Clementine.
down by water, still she lay.
out. She just opened her throat and swallowed a note. She swallowed a note to catch the cat. She swallowed the cat to catch the bird. She swallowed the bird to catch the spider. Little auntie ran to the spider. She swallowed the spider to catch the fly.
And I curse my poverty, and I wish that I.
wish blood had his guns and had a tiny battle ball. One Sunday morning, London guns are fishing on the weir. He caught a kind of fish upon his ear, he caught the dog's weir. But what a kind of fish it was, he landed from the hotel. He didn't want to carry it on, so he hoisted to Noel. Wish blood had his guns and had a tiny Lambton felt inclined to go and fight in foreign war. He joined a troop of knights that cared for neither wounds nor scars. And off he guns to Palestine, where queer things he befell. And there he soon forgot about the queer one to the well. Wish lads had you gone, so tell you it's all an awful story. Wish lads had you gone, so tell you about the war. His world got fat and grew and grew and got in awful size. With gippy teeth and gippy gob and gippy gobby eyes. And when at night he crawled about to pick up bits of news, if he felt dry upon the way, he'd milk a dozen coos. He'll tell them, wish lads had his dogs, I'll tell you his all about the story. Wish lads had his dogs, I'll tell you about the walls. This fearful world would often feed on cars and lambs and sheep. It swallowed up the bears alive and nearly down to sleep. And when he'd eaten all he could and he had had his fill, he'd crawl away and rock his tail 10 times round Venture Hill. Wish lads had you gone, so tell you it's all an awful story. Wish lads had you gone, so tell you it's wonderful. The news about this awful world when it queer gallons on, they travelled till they reached the ears of brave and bold Sir John. So home he came and catch the beast and cut it in 3 halves. And that's who's got the eaten lambs and bears and sheep and calves. Wish lads had you gone, I'll tell you it's all an awful story. Wish lads had you gone, I'll tell you about the war. So now you know why all the folks on both sides of the weir lost lots of sheep and lots of sheep and they did more than fear. So let's a song to brave Sir John who kept the bench from harm and coos and calves by mat and halves of the terrible mountain warm. Wish lads had you gone, so tell you it's all an awful story. Wish lads had you gone, so tell you about the war. New lads have had me gone, but tell an art about the story of Sir John's clever job with the famous London worm.
As a child, when I lived in Fatfield, Kirk Durham, I used to slide down that hill on bits of cardboard in the summer, which was fine until the cardboard moved. Then it was me sliding down there, which wasn't that good. I spoke earlier about the universality of coal mining, and this song is from Kentucky in the USA. And it was written in 1931 by a lady called Florence Weiss, when there was a big dispute between the coal owners and the miners. And in those days, they used clubs and guns to settle disputes, not acres. So this song was called Which Side Are You Going? It's a wonderful song, one of my favourites. There's no chorus, but there's that refrain. So please don't refrain from the refrain. So I'm saying Which Side Are You Going? Which Side Are You Going?
Oh,
She'll be coming round.
Come on.
Do we want to see this?
Yeah.
What do you need them for?
You're
not even
a judge.
St. Jude?
No.
What?
want you to do it on one leg.
See
what I mean? With all
your hands. One leg. What's the empty bit? I'm making it.
One hand.
Just a minute.
Tomorrow, teeth and her hair. She plays on in a chair, side by side. I lost faith forever when her glass eye so small, with her arm and her leg tied together, she hung on a nail on the wall. Now I was quite broken hearted, with half of me bride I had parted. So I stepped on the chair, there was four of her there, side by side.
Once I longed before perfection, one whose thoughts were dear to me, till there came a dreary parting. Nevermore he'll think of me, cause oh, leave me if you wish to.
Oh, fancy I'm bound far away. The ship is awaiting out there in the bay. The anchor is hoisted, she waits the next flowing tide. Romantic end. And if
she's pretty. chance to play harmonica, which is the only time.